Hello everyone and welcome to the awesome biology channel, where today I'm going to be talking to you about this process of transcription, where we can use a DNA template to get out an RNA transcript. And we're going to be talking about this in a big and beautiful group of organisms. That's right, we're speaking about today the prokaryotes, the bacteria and the archaea. Now we're going to look at how a big monster of an enzyme, the RNA polymerase, can come in and in three phases of initiation, elongation and termination,
crank out an RNA transcript from a DNA template. So let's start by looking at the DNA. All right.
Okay, so let's consider a stretch of prokaryotic DNA. Now remember that DNA is double-stranded, right? So I've shown the coding strand up the top and that template strand down the bottom. Now everything that that DNA needs to make an RNA molecule, it's contained within what we call a transcription unit. And this includes, at the start, a promoter region, right, which is going to be important for the initiation of transcription. And that promoter region itself, it includes the site at which RNA is actually going to start being transcribed from. Now, after the promoter region, there's a stretch of DNA that will end up being transcribed into RNA. That's called the RNA coding region. And right at the end, we've got a terminator region. And right at the end of the terminator region, there's a site that'll signal the end of transcription, right? So when transcription happens, we actually only get the RNA synthesized between that initiation site of transcription and then that termination site right at the end. And between those, we'll have our RNA molecule made. Okay, if we consider this in embroidery cotton form, we've got here a template strand and up the top the coding strand. Here I am in the promoter. That RNA transcription site is sometimes referred to as plus one. And that really just refers to the very first nucleotide of DNA that's going to get transcribed into RNA. And we use this to number the rest of the nucleotides too. So the second one will be plus two and the third one will be plus three. Now, if we have a look at the beast who's going to be doing the work, the RNA polymerase, we've got five subunits to this bad boy, two betas, two alphas, and an omega. Together, they make up the core enzyme. But if we added a sixth subunit onto this,
well, hello.
Then together, this sigma factor plus the core enzyme makes the holoenzyme. And he's going to be doing some of the work at the start. Now, remember our DNA, it's wound, right? It's a double helix. So here we are wound up. We're in the promoter. That holo enzyme, he's bound now to the promoter. Oh, I added an I because he's like a monster. Now, just a naming convention, we say everything to the left is upstream and going down right is downstream. Our RNA holoenzyme has bound to two sites, a minus 35 and a minus 10 site. These are named with these numbers. They just refer to how far back they are from that plus one site of RNA transcription, the start site. Now, at that minus 10 site, that RNA holoenzyme, he's going to be pulling apart those two strands of DNA. So he denatures it, and then he travels downstream, right? He walks, and as he goes, that wound DNA, it unwinds in his body, and then it rewinds behind him. Now, just for what I'm going to show you next, that bottom strand here is the template strand of DNA. So right now we're at the RNA start site. Just imagine in the cell, we've got all of these bases around, right? These nucleoside triphosphates, the C's, the G's, the A's, and the U's. And imagine our actual sequence on the DNA. Let's say it starts with ACT, the first three nucleotides. Now that holoenzyme, he's going to suck in those bases, right? And he's going to start stitching them together. They'll be the complement of what is on the DNA. So here the complement of the A is the U, the C is the G, and the T is the A. So he's starting to get those bases in and he will stitch them together into a growing RNA strand. And he'll keep doing this. He'll keep taking them in until he's transcribed about somewhere between 8 and 12 nucleotides into RNA. And then the sigma factor is going to dissociate. And this signals the end of initiation.
Goodbye, sigma factor. I'll always remember initiation with you. I'll miss you, polymerase.
Okay, so our initiation phase that we've just seen, it starts with that holoenzyme binding to the promoter, all right? Inside his little body, he's going to pull that DNA apart and he's going to transcribe RNA as a complement of the template strand. Once he's done about 8 to 12 nucleotides, a sigma factor will fall off, and then the next phase is elongation. So in elongation, we've got our RNA core polymerase enzyme. He's there on that DNA region. He's pulled apart the two strands inside his body. This makes a transcription bubble, and this is where that enzyme is going to be working to add those bases to a growing RNA transcript. See how they're coming in there, but that RNA is directional, right? That 3' end of RNA, it's always going to be at the front end of that elongating strand, and that's always going to be where those bases get added to. So we say RNA elongates 5' to 3'.
I'm RNA polymerase. My job is making RNA 5', to 3'. I elongate. RNA is a complement of the template strand of DNA.
Elongation! Okay, so in elongation, we had that transcription bubble being made, that little local region of denatured DNA, and our new NTPs, or our new bases, were always added at the 3' end of that growing RNA strand. Okay, now the next phase we've got is termination. There are two different kinds of termination, right? Intrinsic termination and Rho dependent termination. So in intrinsic termination, here we can see the terminator region. We've got our RNA core polymerase enzyme. It's going to go through, keep transcribing that, that RNA. But in this region of the DNA, there's two sites of DNA which are complementary to each other. Now that core enzyme, he keeps going and elongating and transcribing them into RNA. So now we've got two sites of RNA which are complementary to each other. And because they are, they switch back on each other and they bind to each other, right? So they form this secondary structure. It's called a hairpin because they're self-complementary. Now, just downstream of this, the DNA codes for a string of A's, which get transcribed into their complement, a string of U's. Now, just as a refresh, remember the C's and the G's together, they're a strong bond because they've got three hydrogen bonds between them. But the A's and the T's, they've only got two hydrogen bonds that keep them together. It's the same for the A's and the U's. So because they've only got two hydrogen bonds each, it means it's a weaker association. Now these two features together, the hairpin and then this very weak RNA-DNA hybrid region, mean that that RNA transcript will want to dissociate from the enzyme and from the DNA strands. And termination is done. Okay, now in Rho-dependent termination, on our terminator region, we've got a rut site, or a Rho utilization site, and a pause site, okay? And our RNA core polymerase enzyme, he's going to go through, he's going to transcribe that rut site onto RNA, and then when he hits the pause site, he's going to slow down his transcription. Now, the rut site that's been transcribed, it's there because of this protein, a Rho helicase protein with 6 subunits. This guy, this helicase, he's actually like a little motor, right? He can spin around if he's using up ATP. So this Rho helicase protein, he can come and bind to that rut site, and then he'll use up ATP to motor his way up the transcript. So he'll like, he'll bunch it all up, and then when he gets up to the core enzyme, he'll act as a helicase, which means he'll separate that RNA from that DNA, from the template strand, and the whole complex will dissociate. Okay, so we had intrinsic termination, where we had that hairpin just next to a region of U's and A's of weak binding, which meant that RNA transcript could come apart from the DNA. And then we had Rho-dependent termination, where we had this Rho helicase protein come and bind to a rut site on the RNA transcript, and then it motored up the transcript and migrated up all the way to the polymerase enzyme, where it acted as a helicase and it pulled apart that RNA from that DNA. I am so stoked for Rho Dependent Termination that I got my skateboard and a remote control car and I acted it out in my backyard. Please click on that video if you're interested. Hey, for everyone out there, if you've got any questions or comments, please put them down in that comment section. If you like the video, please do us a favor and give us a thumbs up. And I look forward to seeing you in the next The Awesome Biology Channel video.
The Awesome Biology Channel. Please subscribe.